how to post process it. Photography in the night is really very exciting and very interesting. And this shooting of a straw tail is such a photography where you can start your photo shoot, sit idle or enjoy with a cup of tea or any snacks for 1 or 2 hours, because this takes almost more than 2 hours to complete the complete shoot. So the most important part is the selection of time period when we can shoot star tails to get the perfection. We call it amavasya, or even 3 to 4 days prior to and after that new moon you can also shoot. Reason being, the sky is totally dark, so stars are visible very clearly. Second part is the sky's condition. The location should be free of dust and light pollution. And very important is to select the foreground. Foreground must be very interesting, either a mountain or any geometrical formation of any architecture, or maybe a historical building. Second thing, you can also place tent in the foreground, and then you can put some light inside the tent to create an interesting foreground. Next, how we get movement of stars? The reason is very simple. Our earth rotates on this north and south axis. Okay, and at the same time the stars also rotate, but with respect to earth, we feel when we shoot a star tail, we feel that the stars are rotating. Again, one more point is very important, that is the location of north star. This is almost at the north pole of the earth, and that's why when we shoot star tail, the north star remains stationary. Next, what equipments are required? The sturdy tripod is a must. Without tripod, you cannot shoot a star tail. If it is having a ball head, it is much preferred.
Yeah, Mukesh, can you start your PowerPoint also with sharing your screen?
It is going on PowerPoint.
You need to share your screen also.
Okay, I think that's missing. From where to share the screen? Oh, start sharing. Oh. Should we start again?
I guess it's okay, you can start.
Should we start again? Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so hi friends, let me repeat what I have said to you. The first important is to select a proper time period in a month. Best day is the new moon day, when the sky is totally dark. In Hindi we call it amavasya. Or you can also shoot a star tail perfectly either 3 to 4 days prior to the new moon day or after the new moon day. This is very important, because we will not talk more about astronomy, but let me introduce this part of astronomy to understand the movement of the stars. The earth rotates at north and south pole. Okay, and the stars are also rotating, but apparently, virtually, we are getting that stars are moving and earth is stationary. Again, this Polaris or north star is very important. This is located almost at the north pole of the earth. That's why when we shoot star tail, we get a north star stationary and other stars are moving. Now, we must know the equipments required to shoot a perfect star tail. study tripod is a must. If you are having a ball head, it is much preferable. Why study? Because we are keeping our camera on the tripod almost for 2 hours or more. So it should not get a shake either with the wind or any other small touch. Camera, you can choose anyone. It may be FX or DX. It doesn't matter. But in case you are not having external timer like MC36, your camera must be equipped with time interval shooting feature. Almost all those camera are having this kind of feature. If it is not having, then you have to go for external timer like Nikon MC36. I will show you afterwards what is that. Second part, compass is essential. Why? Because you have to know the north direction, because that is the best composition for a star trail, where a dot comes in form of north star and around that dot the stars are moving. You can also get compass from mobile application, but as per my experience goes, this mobile compass sometimes fail to show the direction accurately. Reason being, at the location, if there is any electric line crossing nearby, then your mobile compass will not work properly. Then comes selection of lens. You can take any wide angle lens of any brand, likewise 16-35, 14-24, and 11-16. Right now, I have in my camera this Tokina 11-16 lens. You also must keep a torch with you. Preferably for travel photographers, this is very handy. Simply you have to mount on the head and you can use it. Because we have to work complete session for hour and two in complete darkness. So never depend on the torch of mobile. Because in case you are using mobile torch, something may fall down and you will have a great loss. Now we have put our camera on the tripod. We have selected the location having a very good foreground. Now comes, let me first brief you about the different settings of the camera. Camera will be definitely in focus, manual focus mode. Image quality, preferably you go for RAW or RAW plus JPEG. Color space, definitely Adobe RGB to give the wide gamut of colors. Picture control, standard. White balance, do not keep auto. Always go for a custom white balance. In case you are shooting nearby city or urban sky, then you can keep it at 3400 to 3900 Kelvin. But in case you are in a remote area, in a village area, and the sky is very dark, then we can keep the custom white balance at 4000 or 4500 degree Kelvin. ISO, first to start with, will keep ISO at 800. Shutter speed 30 seconds. Then comes aperture, F value. You can keep F4 to start with. Okay. In the camera, there is a setting for long exposure noise reduction that we should keep it off. Then, now the camera setting has been done. I will repeat the setting, F4, ISO 800, shutter speed 30 seconds. Custom white balance, say 4000 degree Kelvin. Now we have to compose your frame, keeping the camera in north direction to cover the north star. In case you are having a source of light, likewise a headlight of a car or a jeep, and then you can put the light on the foreground. In that situation, you can focus on the foreground with your camera by manual focus mode. In case you are not having that, then the problem comes how to focus in the dark sky, in the dark night. That's the real problem. So for that, you see your camera. In the camera, there is a focus ring where you can rotate the focus ring. Okay, in the end, you will find an infinity sign. So just keep, say, 1 millimeter before infinity. In that case, your camera is well focused to capture the foreground as well as the background. Okay. After that, you first take a trial shot in the same situation. In case you are getting a dark frame, then you can increase the ISO. In case you are getting a bright frame, you can decrease the ISO. Then you enlarge the image to almost 4 to 6 times and check the sharpness of the star. If it is a dot and well sharp, it means your focus is perfectly correct. If not, then simply rotate the focus ring little bit left and right and again take a trial shot. Once you are satisfied that my stars are coming very bright, then you start shooting. Before shooting, you have to take a blank shot so that you will know in your computer from where we have started. So for taking a blank shot, simply keep your handkerchief or keep the lens cap and take a blank shot. This is also very important. This shutter viewfinder window must be closed. Every camera has got a system to close the door. Why? Because in the background there may be some light which can enter in the camera and it will spoil the sharpness of your image. Keep a soft cloth with you, because mostly we shoot such a star trail in Himalayan range, and that too because there is winter in that period. So there may be some moisture coming on the lens. So you keep on cleaning the moisture very frequently, maybe after 5 minutes or 10 minutes. But you must take a care that camera on the tripod should not get disturbed. So before shooting, if you have got a timer, you can see this timer. This is Nikon MC36 timer, and this is my preferred one. I always use this for a star trail because this gives me very accurate numbers. In case your camera has got a interval timer shooting, then you can set in the camera, and for this you can refer your manual how to set this. Okay, this is the way we can shoot and set your interval timer shooting technique, and you can simply press the button, start the shooting, and this will keep on clicking off its own after every 30 seconds. Now about this MC36, this is a very professional timer for this kind of astrophotography. Let me brief you how to set this. This is a cycle. This is the exposure time, which is 30 seconds in our case. And this is the time when the image is being stored in the memory card. That is the writing time. Okay. So there are three things to set here. One is the delay. Delay means after how much time the camera should start shooting number of frames for the star trail. Second is exposure time, that is 30 seconds already we have set. And then interval. Interval is the addition of exposure time as well as the writing time of the memory card. To get a faster click, you must have a very fast memory card above 90 MB per second. So now, after setting the time, after the setting the number of frames, say you are set 150 or 250, even you can set even 50 frames. But again, the star trail will not be that much form line. So preferably we should go for minimum 150 frames to 250 frames to get a comfortably very good start. Then after capturing, you need to download on the computer. After downloading, first you can use either Lightroom or Photoshop. I will show you how to process it, and then the best software for stacking is the StarStax, which is which can be downloaded free. And after processing, you can enhance the image in the Photoshop. Before I show the actual processing of the frames, let me show you some images and let me tell you something what do's and don'ts about the star scale photography. This is an image I captured in Bikaner because that time here the space was very limited. So I used fish eye lens. Because of fish eye lens, I am getting this kind of distortion. To some extent, it is not a good frame. But again, with the help of fish eye lens, you can be very creative in creating a unique foreground. This was shot in Pushkar in 2016. Again, this was also shot in Pushkar in different location in 2014. This was having around 170 images. This one I am showing you because mostly we say that there is not any light pollution. So I took up a challenge in nearby my place, and there was street lights glowing everywhere around that area. So I tried and I got a wonderful colorful background, but I got the structure. This I want to show you because as I told you earlier, in the foreground should be very, very attractive. If it is a historical monument, it is wonderful. This is an image captured by a very senior landscape photographer, Ken Lee of USA. He has used this church as a foreground. Second image I am showing you, captured by Umesh Gugna of Rajasthan. He is also a very good landscape photographer. And this image I am showing because mostly we go for keeping our camera towards north to get this kind of composition. This is the north star, and the stars are rotating around here. But sometimes if you change the direction, you get amazing started. This was shot by Umesh Gugna, keeping the camera towards eastern direction. So this is the east direction. So you are getting this rotation clockwise, and here I am getting a anti-clockwise. So this gives a different unique frame. Now we'll do the actual processing. These are the frames captured in Pushkar. Actually, I captured around 170 frames, but to save time, I am just taking only 41 frames. Okay, so just select all the 41 frames captured and drag and drop in the Photoshop. It's a very simple process. This is the first image. Okay. First of all, we should do the correction of chromatic aberration and then lens profile correction. Then we will come to white balance. Here, as shot is 4700 something. So let us keep it 4000, because 4000 will be ideal for this kind of dark location. Now you are getting the image dark, so just increase little bit exposure. Some shadow from here. Reduce some highlights. Since stars are in white in color, so increase a bit white. Do not touch the setting of clarity or dehazing here, because this will add noise to your frame. Okay, I think this much is enough to start with, and then from here you select all. So all 41 images are selected. Now you synchronize the setting. So sync settings means ki whatever settings you have done to the first image, this will be applied to all other 40 images. Here check all and then click OK. Okay, so now all images are synchronized. Then you save these images. You can select a folder from here. You can also change the image quality from here. Say I have kept it 8 to 9 image quality, just to get a small file. Otherwise, you can go for the highest quality, that is 12. Keep it 12 here, and then save. I will take time in saving, so straight away I am going folder where the image has been saved. These are the images saved earlier. Okay, so now we'll open StarStack software. Let me locate where I have kept it. Just a minute. Just hold for a minute. Let me locate the StarStack. Oh, finally, I got it. So this is StarStack. Okay, this software is freely available on the net. You can download it. It's a very small software and very fast and very accurate. Now simply take all those raw processed JPEG file from here, select all, and simply drag and drop here. Okay, now you must set here gap filling, so that wherever there gaps are being created by the stars, that gap will be filled up to get a firm line, and then you start processing. Go to edit, start processing. Now you can see gradually each and every image is being stacked, and you are able to see the formation of the star trail. It may take hardly 4 to 5 minutes to complete the sequence. You can watch here, each and every image is getting stacked one by one. Almost 50% is done. Just last image is remaining. Now, in star stacks, you can do processing of threshold. Switch it on here. This is the highlight part. It's being shown by the green color. So you can adjust from here to get rid of highlight part in the sky. Okay, this is done. Now simply go to file and save it. Okay. And after processing, this image has been saved here. So this is the final image after stacking. Okay. Now you can process it further in the Photoshop to enhance the color, sharpness, and clarity. And now, I think you must have enjoyed it. Thank you very much.
If you have any question, please.
Yes, we have some questions.
Let's make it very interactive.
Sure. So we have a question. Can we batch process 150 images in a Lightroom? Is there any limit on Lightroom? Can you hear me, Mukesh? Can you hear me? Mukesh, can you hear me? Hello? Mukesh, we can see you, but we cannot hear you. Can you hear us?
Friends.
Okay. Mukesh, there is a question.
Whatever doubt you are having in the startle shooting and processing, please come out. I am here to clarify your doubts.
Can you hear me now? Can you hear me, Mukesh? Mukesh. Hi Mukesh, can you hear us? Mukesh, can you hear?
Yeah, I'm hearing you. Is my voice clear?
Hello?
Hello.
Yeah, I think now you can hear.
Yeah.
Okay, so ignore that phone, Rajesh was calling you. So, first question is, is there any limit on...
Wait, let me. Yeah, carry on.
Is there any limit on Lightroom to process the image? Like maximum number of images?
No, there is no limit. You can keep any number of images, maybe 200, 300, 400, 500.
Okay.
But mostly around 250 number of images are enough to get a firm line of the curve. Okay.
Great. We have another question.
Okay.
You have already answered this, that what white balance we should keep with the city lights.
Okay. So that I have told you earlier, it is around 3400 to 3800 degree Kelvin. Because in what happens around the city, you will definitely get some sort of light pollution. So once you go to the darker area, likewise the remote village area, then we can keep the white balance 4000 degree Kelvin.
Okay. In between, you have used a software. Could you please tell the name of that software?
That is Star Stacks. STAR Star, STAX Stacks, and this is freely downloadable from the net.
Okay, we have another question from Tiger0895.
Okay.
Does including true dark images in the stack reduces the noise? If yes, please give us a reason in detail.
Yes, what happens, first of all, we should try to keep as minimum as possible the ISO, okay, but in case the sky is very dark, we may need to go to almost 1200 or 1600 ISO. There will be a bit noise. Sometimes we get noise above 1200 ISO. In that case, we have to use any noise filter. Likewise, Ninja is available and other softwares are there.
Okay. We have a question. This question is from Harry.
Okay.
Is there? Give us some technique to stabilize the frame. So you already gave about the steady tripod. But if there is any other tips and tricks, if you could share.
I don't think without tripod you can do this. Okay. So tripod is very essential, and that it must be very sturdy, because sometimes in remote areas, likewise in Himalayan range, you get wind also in the night. So that tripod must be able to bear that wind velocity.
Okay, we have a question like, what are the some good locations in India to capture the star trails?
Yeah. Ladakh is the ideal place where you can get wonderful foreground. Likewise, Pangong Lake and other areas in Ladakh. Again, Uttarakhand is also very good locations. You can get, like Kausani is there, where you get the complete mountain range. Then Munsiyari is there. The one you are seeing on the screen, that is shot in Munsiyari. The mountain range is the Panchachuli peaks. And the reason is very clear, because in those areas the sky is totally dust free and there is no dust pollution. That's why you are seeing so many stars. Otherwise, if you shoot some other areas nearby the city, you cannot get this kind of number of stars getting like a star trend.
We have a lot of people are shooting, you know, despite that lot of negativity which is going on right now because of this corona.
Okay.
But some of the good things which have come up is people have started shooting stars right from the city, like in Delhi, even in Delhi, and Gurgaon, Noida, Bangalore, people are shooting from their home.
Yeah.
What is your experience on that?
Yeah, because what happens during this lockdown period, the environment is almost pollution free because there is no smoke coming out from the vehicles. So people are using that their rooftop to capture star trails. But again, they miss that kind of foreground, because those kind of foregrounds are only available when you go to some Himalayan range, then you get some good foreground.
Okay, nice. Some of the questions people are asking, which are already covered by you. So this is for everyone. The recording will be available. It will be available on our channel, on YouTube channel. So don't worry, you can listen to this recording and get that information. Because we have many questions, we don't want to waste time on these, because otherwise we will be short of time. We have another question. Why sky is not kept dark to make it look like
Please repeat the question. There are some audio problem.
So this is about your frame. Why sky is not kept dark?
That recent image which I processed. Is it so? The image which I processed just now during my deliberation. Uh-huh. Are you talking about that image?
Yes.
Yes. See, that time actually this was shot very in the Pushkar, just by the side of the main highway. Because that was the only location where in the north direction I could get a range of mountains. So there was some light pollution on the sky also. That's why the sky could not come black, dark. But again, if you see this Munsiyari star trail, where the sky is completely dark.
Okay.
One more star trail you have seen, where the sky is having a colorful light because of the street lights. So that too we can try. We can try something different.
Yeah, agree with you. Have another question. Should we shoot in RAW or in JPEG?
Preferably in RAW, because in RAW, we get the image in a data form. It's not an image, it's a data. So the details are too much in RAW. whereas in JPEG we miss details or the color gambits. So it is always preferred to shoot in RAW.
Okay. We have another question. This is, what to do to avoid any wash out of your foreground, so that foreground is not, you know, overexposed?
See, in case you are using some additional light to lighten the foreground, you have to have a test shot to see whether it is overexposed or not. If it is overexposed, either you keep the vehicle far away to reduce the intensity of light falling on the foreground.
Okay. We have more questions. It's again kind of a repeated, but maybe it is being asked by many people. What is the lens, which is the best lens we should use for this?
See, as far as my experience goes, I like 1635, that is the Nikon's lens. And second, my preference is Tokina 1160. You can also go for 1424 of Nikon, but 1635 is the best lens I have come across for this kind of photo shoot.
Okay, great. We have multiple more questions as well. Apart from, as a, you know, like you have told the tool, what is the, some of the app you can suggest, like mobile app, to track the sky, to track certain information related to astrophotography?
Right now, I don't have those informations with me, but there is one app, Selenium, there's a mobile app in which we can get the instant position of the sky.
Okay.
And particularly that is very helpful to know the timing and the location of the Milky Way. That is very helpful for Milky Way. But as far as Star Trail is concerned, we don't need any mobile app, because simply we have to take care about the new moon period. And the direction, north or south or east or west.
Another question we have, I'm interested in capturing the ISS. Do you have any such experience?
No, I don't have experience of capturing ISS.
Okay. Another question we have, what is your opinion about career as a astrophotographer, like how we can make it as a career?
As a career, simply if you are interested, we can go for a stock photography, because in stock photography, such good images of astrophotography are being sold quite well. Likewise, one of the sites where I am selling my images, that is the Dreams Time, and they prefer landscapes, beautiful landscapes, the astrophotography and all.
Okay. We have another question. Can you recommend any tripod which is in budget as well as good quality?
I think the only name comes to my mind is the Manfrotto. What I am using, that Manfrotto 190X. But it is a bit heavy, so nowadays you can get a carbon fiber tripod. So lightweight, but again, I have a carbon fiber tripod also, but still I prefer my Manfrotto 190X for any kind of landscape, because this is very sturdy, even for macro I'm very happy with this tripod.
Thank you. We have a question from Bhumika.
Yeah.
And the question is that photo with the back light, the street light, I guess it was from Pushkar or somewhere.
Yeah.
There are still cloud, but how you are able to get still the clear sky?
In the image which I have shown during processing.
You have shown one image, there was some cloud. There was some light coming on and which added more drama to picture.
Yeah. Okay, that one, that yellow color light.
Yes.
So this I shot during my workshop near Dharmad only, in Maithak. So there we had a problem because everywhere there was a street light. There is a power plant also. So finally we went to a quite remote area. Even then I saw that halogen light, and that yellow color, sodium vapor lamp light. So I thought, let us try here, because that hill is the black, will come as a black, and in the background we will get some yellow color light. Let us try star kill there. And that was my first endeavor to try in the light pollution. And I was very happy with that result.
Okay. We have another question. Can you suggest a good light meter or intervalometer for amateurs, like some budget one?
I think this Nikon FC36 is not very costly. It costs hardly, I think, 1200 to 1500 INR. It's not very costly.
It will work only on Nikon or?
This will work on Nikon only. No, I think it will work on Canon also.
Okay. Nice, thank you. And there is another question, like again, what should I do to become an astrophotographer? I think it's a very basic question, but important.
You see, astrophotography is a very wide area. Okay, the star trail is just a glass of water, if I compare with a pond. Okay, so astrophotography is a very, very wide area and very interesting also. And the knowledge of astronomy is very essential, backed up with your photographic skill. And one can do miracle.
Okay, we have a question from Kumar. Do you teach astrophotography? If yes, when is your next batch starting?
I could not get you.
Do you teach astrophotography?
Yeah. Actually, I'm the author of a book. That is the first Indian book on digital photography. And you can see this book in my hand. This is my book. And each and every kind of photo shoot has been described here. And in this book, one thing I have mentioned, I have given it big tables. In that table, any kind of photography has been mentioned in the left. And in the right, I have mentioned the camera setting. Starting from landscape, and then shooting in moonlight, then waterfall, then macro, and everything. So that is the only available in my book, and that is as per my experience.
Okay. And can you suggest where, if somebody is interested, where to buy this book?
This book is available online from Flipkart and Snapdeal. The book I am showing is my first edition, but the second edition was published in 2015, and that second edition has some additional chapters on post processing. This is a complete handbook.
Oh, okay, nice.
This book has got the foreword from the Secretary General of Federation of Indian Photography, as well as the MD of Nikon India Limited, Mr. Sajjan Kumar.
Oh, great!
And this book is being used as a test book in one of the photographic schools in Calcutta, that is IPA in Dum Dum, as well as in Indore, Allahabad, in every colleges and schools where the photography is being taught, this book is being used as a reference book.
Oh, that's really amazing. We have another question from Darshan Podar. Hi Mukesh, I am from Mumbai. Can you suggest some ways to sharpen my astrography or astrophotographs, making them more grainy or seems more processed? How do professional astrophotographer get such sharp images? You mean like he gets grainy or his images are not that sharp what your images are or any other professional astrophotographers?
I do agree. Well, what happens is for to get a noise-free image, the lens quality is very essential, as well as the type of camera you are using. Okay, that sensor is also very important. So likewise, earlier I was using D800E of Nikon, where the ISO capability was very low, not very high. And nowadays I am using D500, where even if I shoot at 1600 ISO, it will be completely noise free. So the role of camera as well as the lens is very important in getting rid of noise in the frame. Of course, processing is also very important.
Okay, great. Before you would be having a second session, before we can have two more questions. One is from Prateek. Sarji, thank you for the webinar. One question, curious to know, how can you take a photo of stars for 6 hours or more? Like a longer duration shot.
Nowadays it's not required because you can take multiple shots. And for that 6 hours and all, again, this timer is required. Because this is the only additional timer which can give you longer duration in hours. In camera, the limitation is 30 seconds, but in few cameras of Nikon, it has gone up to 15 minutes, because those cameras are meant only for astrophotographers. I think that is D810S or something. I am not remembering the name, brand of that camera. But there is a camera from Nikon having a 15 minutes of shutter speed used by the astrophotographer.
Okay, great.
I think it's a Nikon 810P or something.
Oh, there is a different variation for Astro.
Yeah, because in most of the camera, the 30 second is the limit. Okay.
Okay, great. We have a question from Vishnu. Do you conduct tours also, Astro tours?
Yes. I also conduct workshop cum tour. Maybe in the coming after lockdown period, I'm planning to go for Kausani, because Kausani is a place where, apart from astrophotography, we can also get some beautiful landscapes having green and yellow geometrical shapes on the land.
Okay. This is the last question before the session. How much the cloud impact the star players? In between the cloud comes, what we can do to avoid them?
Actually, when there is a cloudy weather, we should avoid to go for a star, because clouds are very unpredictable. Sometimes it may be very dark, so no stars will be visible. Again, in every frame, you will get different kind of locations of the clouds. So once it is being stitched, the final image will be totally a garbage. So we should avoid shooting in cloudy weather. only the sky is, when the sky is very clear, we can see the stars very well. Then only we can go for star trail.
Okay. And some people have asked your contact details and your handle. If you could share yourself, that would be great.
How can I share it here? Can I type somewhere, or I can tell? I think I'm available in Instagram as Mukesh Srivastava. I'm also in Facebook. I have got three pages on the Facebook. One is the Center for Visual Arts. That is the page under which I conduct workshops and photo tours. Second is Mukesh Photography, and third is Mukesh Srivastava. Apart from that, the participants can note down my email address, mailmukesh123@gmail.com.
Okay. Yeah, that is easy. mailmukesh123@gmail.com. Okay, great. So we have more questions, but I think we will hold as of now. We can continue the second part of your presentation, and okay, the remaining question we will take your time.
Okay.
Okay. So please continue. You are. You can start sharing your screen now. Your presenter.
Anything else I can share now? Because whatever I had my presentation on this star trail, it's already over. In case someone is interested.
Some of your work, some story behind that, and how those photos were made.
Okay. That part. Okay, fine. Let me tell you. That's very interesting. I will tell the story behind this image. You must be seeing some blurred area here. Am I audible?
You are audible, but we cannot see your screen.
Oh, we are not seeing my screen. Let me. Now my screen is visible?
Not yet.
What is going wrong?
You could share and start your presentation or your photos.
Of what?
Okay, let me share the screen once again.
Yeah.
Let me give you that option. So please start sharing. You will get an option now, and you can start sharing your screen.
Sure.
Yeah, please go ahead and share now.
Should I share now?
Please.
Is it visible?
Have you clicked all screen share?
Is it visible now?
No.
You
need to minimize that screen and then show your photos.
I'm not getting that screen of that webinar screen.
It must be minimized on your Google Chrome.
Google Chrome, okay. Now I'm getting it. Start sharing. Okay. Hello, now it's visible?
Yes.
Yes, yeah. This is the picture I captured at Moon CRA. I stayed in a government guest house. It was very cold. It was almost 0 degrees centigrade in the night. Is done in the night only. So how to stay in the open sky with temperature of 0 degree? It was a great challenge for me. So what I did, after wearing all gloves and everything, I set the camera, and then I had a car. So I kept the car nearby the tripod. And then after setting everything, I came back to the car. I sat there and I was having some tea and coffee in the thermos. I used to sip it. Away coming here. So while processing, I had to remove those areas, and that's why this mountain is not very clear. So in this situation, what I suggest everyone to go as close as possible to the foreground, and to avoid anything coming in between the foreground and the camera. Here I did a mistake because there was no option left to me, because I cannot go in remote areas in such a cold weather. So there was only one left. Now I will show you that image where I dare to shoot the star trail under light pollution. But I was very happy in case I can get some beautiful architecture here in the foreground. This will be fantastic image and totally noise free. This image was captured in Pushkar. I conducted two workshops in Pushkar. One is in 2014 and second in 2016. So before conducting workshop for a star trail, I need to select the area, and the selection of that area is most important for such kind of photography. Again, the area should not be very much remote where the participants can get some trouble and all. So keeping in mind, I selected this area just by the side of the main road. And again, there was a breeze of RCC. So the participants can sit there and enjoy snacks and all during the hours and 2 hours of shooting period. So that was the right location. And again, I am getting a mountain state in the north. Composition is also fantastic for this. Another one. Again from Pushkar. Here the location is a bit changed, and this is the north direction. Anything else can I share? Hello.
Whatever work you want to show, we can do it, and then we will move to question answer before finishing this webinar. So as of now, we have a full house. More people would not be able to join. So guys, please don't leave the webinar. Otherwise, you won't be able to join back. There are several people waiting to be joined this. So you can, Mukesh, you can continue and sharing your work. And once you are done, then we will take it next.
Can I share some landscapes of Iceland?
Sure, please.
Okay, fine. Just hold on, let me locate. Where's that? Just give me 1 minute. I have to collect the external hard disk before I start.
That's not a problem.
Thank God, I got it collected now. Finally, I got it. Is it visible to you all? Hello.
It is visible. Please continue.
This is the very rare thing which we get in the world. Only there are 6 countries where we can get this northern light. And we stayed in Iceland for around 2 weeks. But only one night we could get this northern light. And then again, before that, we always tried to stay in a hotel nearby some iconic places. So this is one of the iconic places of this waterfall. And then suddenly we got around, say, 10 o'clock that northern light has come. And it's such a beautiful light that after capturing 5 or 6 images, I stopped shooting because I wanted to enjoy the drama of this northern light. So finally I captured only 10 images and then I switched off my camera because after all I am a human being, I love nature. So I started enjoying the nature. So this is the northern light in Iceland. Now one of the important part of Iceland, the population of horses are more than the human being. They are the unique country. This is wonderful landscape, having this cottage. This is a church. I'll show you some this is the location. It's called the Vestrahorn area of Iceland, and this is the Vestrahorn, and here the sand and the soil is black everywhere because of volcano is too much in Iceland, so complete soil and is totally black. This is another view of Vestrahorn. This is very interesting because we had a model from Mexico, she's Joe, and in this you can say area where the temperature was -4, and she was so daring, she posed for us. Let me show some other images. This is also very important location. This is the wreck plane of USA which crashed in Iceland, and people have seen that movie of Rang De Tu Mohe Gerua in which Shah Rukh Khan is there. So on this plane that Kajol was dancing. This is almost 6 kilometers away from the main road. Then I will show you, this is the wonderful location. This is called Black Sand Beach. Then I had a dream to shoot a foreign model in a foreign land wearing Indian costume. So I carried Indian sari and blouse, and then I captured these frames in that black sand beach area. This is also an iconic location of Iceland. This is called Kirkjufell. This is another iconic location of Iceland, which is called Skógafoss. I think this is all from the Iceland trip. Let me show you something from Pushkar if I get it here. Yes. Last year in Pushkar, people have never done any fashion shoot in Pushkar fair. So I decided let us do something different than what I have done in past few years. So luckily I got a contact with a classical dancer. She lives in Pushkar only, and we did some photo shoots with her. These are the normal photo shoots, very common, and this is different. About this picture, I will tell the story behind this picture. Suddenly, in one night, there was rain. Second morning, I just came this area. Then I saw a small potholes with water. Then suddenly, I came this side. and I saw wonderful reflection coming. So then I waited for this karma to come, because in the morning hour, this camel karma, after grazing grass and all from the remote areas, they come back to the fairground. So when I got this karma, again, this Savitri temple in the background, it was a wonderful composition, and I captured this. And this image was published in the front page of Dainik Bhaskar of Ajmer. This is a very common camel dance. This is just some fun shots. I think this is all to show. Is there any question from anybody?
We have some questions. Should we start with that?
Sure, sure, sure.
Okay. So we let me start with the question with the earlier presentation. One of the question is which is the best star trail you have captured as per your personal?
That is the Anchichuli Peak star trail.
Oh, okay.
Because the density of the stars are very, very high.
Mm-hmm.
And that night was very, very clear. So I was lucky to get that much high density of stars. Normally, you will not see such images where this kind of density of the stars is visible.
Okay. We have a question from Dipanya. How to show Milky Way in the moonlight?
See, Milky Way, we have to use that mobile app to know the timing and all. And then the only thing, as I remember, for Milky Way, there is a rule of 500. Means you have to keep the shutter speed equal to 500 divided by the focal length of the lens. So if I am using a 50 millimeter lens, then if I divide 500 by 50, I get 10. So I have to keep the shutter speed for 10 seconds to get the proper Milky Way. One more tip to capture Milky Way is the custom white balance. For Milky Way, the ideal custom white balance is around 4450 degree Kelvin. Again, as far as composition is concerned, even for the Milky Way, the foreground is very, very important. Simply capturing Milky Way in the sky has got no much impact unless we have a very beautiful and iconic foreground. Yeah. Next question.
Okay. Next question we have from Dipanjan.
Please discuss some technique to shoot Star Trail and Milky Way in Northern Lights.
What happens because of dust and light pollution, sometimes Milky Way is not visible in city areas. But in case it is visible, we can definitely capture, there is no problem. For a Star Trail, definitely we can just move a bit away from the city. And in the outer skirt, definitely we can get less light pollution. Definitely we'll have dust pollution. So because of this dust pollution, what is the problem? The density of the stars will be very low. So only countable number of stars we can get. So we cannot get the density like what I got in this Munsiyari at Panchachuli Peak. But we can definitely capture.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you. That clarifies. Now, another question which we have, like, could you check my images? So I know that is not possible. There is a request that could you review my work? That is not possible. Another questions which we have, like, who do you get inspired, any Indian astrophotographer? Who you follow?
I follow Umesh Bhogna because he's a wonderful astrophotographer and he's a master landscape photographer. He's the mentor of Sony also. And almost every year he takes at 5 to 6 trips of the Himalayan areas. I follow him.
Okay.
And as a friend of mine,
you suggest people to Astro or any other website, any other place where they can keep themselves that what to be done?
I think the one I have shown you that Ken Lee, he's a very good landscape photographer and I'm fond of his photography. But anyway, we can always search in the pool and get the idea of good landscape photographers. Even in the Instagram also we can find such photographers that we can follow.
Okay, great. We have another question. What's your story? How you got into photography and how you got into Astro?
When I was in the third year of my engineering, then suddenly I used to see newspapers, ki some photographs are published and all. That time definitely we don't have much money to buy a camera also. And that was the film camera is. So I got some attraction. I too want to capture some photographs and I want to see those photographs being published in the newspaper. So I went to my uncle who was posted there in the as police inspector. He had a Zenith camera. So I asked him, can you spare this camera for a couple of months? Bole, yes, Mukesh, you can take it because I am not using and I am not fond of photography. So you can take and use it for a couple of months. So in Bihar, I did my engineering from Bihar. So in Bihar, there is a Chhath festival. Very captured a frame and that I sent to a newspaper and it was published next day. That was the day which really inspired me to go ahead with this kind of hobby. And that was the, you can say, foundation for my hobby to grow in future. So from there I started and then I kept on going.
Oh, great, because you are one of the photographers, those who are from the previous generation. And I'm sure you must have started with your film camera.
Film camera, 120 roll, then 35 millimeter. And then when digital camera came, I never bought a point and shoot camera because it was not liked by me. So I waited for a DSLR to come in the market before buying a digital camera. I think it was in year 2005 when the Nikon D70S came to the market, and that price tag was 1 lakh. So even I was not able to afford that much money. So I waited for 6 months. When the price tag came down to 75,000, then I bought my first Nikon D70S camera with a kit lens of 2870.
Oh, great.
And then I can give you the idea, the result of that camera, because I must mention it here. Nowadays, all cameras have got CMOS sensor. And those generations of Nikon cameras, they had the CCD sensor.
Okay.
Although that Nikon D70S is a 6.1 megapixel camera, but using that camera and the Tamron simple lens 7300, which costed at that time around 4,000 bucks. So using that 6.1 megapixel camera and Tamron 7300 lens, I captured that sunbird sipping water from the tap. And that image I'm having in my house, framed in the size of 30 inches by 30 inches without any pixelation. Nowadays, even with this CMOS sensor camera, we cannot get that kind of quality. What I got it with the CCD sensor. The second camera was also having CCD sensor, that is D700.
Oh, that's nice. That's wonderful. So, Miss, what is Miss, what is your current kit you have? Like, which camera you have? What all the different lenses you have in your kit now?
Yeah, I'll tell you. Still, I'm having my D70S, then D700, then I bought a D800E. Presently, I'm having D500, and I'm really I love this D500. Then I will tell you about the lenses. I also give an advice to all the participants that never be crazy in buying any lens or camera. Before buying any lens or camera, ask yourself a few questions. Why you need this lens? Why you need this camera? Do you really require this or not? Can't you carry on with the present set of whatever you are having? So one should be very selective in buying the lenses, because the lenses are very costly. So in the, from the very beginning, I was very selective. After that 2870 kit lens, the first lens I bought is 50 millimeter 1.4. Then I bought 105 macro 2.8. Then I bought 28-300 normal zoom lens, which I normally use for my traveling, because in traveling one has to be very light. So one lens can get me everything while traveling. And then for landscape, I added 16-35, then 11-16 Tokina. One more fisheye lens I have got, that is 10-17 of Tokina. And that is the full frame lens. And that lens is a magical lens. I am using that lens since 2005, and my most of the creative fashion photography is being captured using that fisheye lens. Apart from that, for wildlife, I took 8400, and then the other, my favorite lens is 7200 2.8. This is all my kit. Again, I have got all kinds of filters required for shooting landscape and all.
Okay, that's really nice. Most of the questions are clear. Let me take a couple of more questions which are a little different. Okay. What's the best season, summer or winter?
What is the best season
for astrophotography?
Okay, I think winter is the ideal time for any kind of photography, including landscape or anything, because in the during winter time, say from the month of November up to say the month of February or March, the morning and evening light is very soft and having that a golden touch. So that is the ideal time, and again the sky is very clear. Unless we have the foggy weather, the sky is very clear, because the winter comes just after rainy season. So the all dust is gone. So to me personally, I like winter season for the photography. But even the summer season is not that bad. Summer season has got its own beauty, like. You can get some cracked field where you can create some good frames using those cracked field located around your city. Again, even the in summer, the light is very harsh and very white. But again, there are ways and means to overcome that harsh light by using flash. I am using for such kind of outdoor areas where sometimes we become late in reaching there. Say it becomes 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, then the light is almost white and very harsh. So I carry my AD400 Godox flash, and that's take care for everything, and I can overcome the white and harshness of the daylight by using that flash.
Okay.
Is it okay? Yeah.
We have a question. Can astrophotography be done using the mobile phone?
I don't think only the Milky Way we can capture using the mobile phone. But I think the star tail, I don't think we can capture. But maybe I'm not aware, maybe some new mobile phones have come with that kind of features, because nowadays a camera of mobile phone is very, very smart, and really, if you call it a smartphone, it is very true. It is very smart. Even for panorama, we used to take a lot of pain, but with a smartphone, we can get panorama very easily. So that those kind of features are being used in the smartphone nowadays.
Okay. Thank you. We have one related question, like how to make star sharper. You have answered this part of this question earlier. But we have another question, like if there is any tip and tricks you can give.
In post-processing, in Photoshop, there is a feature called shadow and highlights. By using that feature, we can create the effect so that the shadow becomes dark and the highlights comes out. In that case, that star tail will be more prominent. Again, if selectively we can increase the white color, then again though that star tail will pop up compared to the background.
But
we should never go for unsharp mask or use of a plugin like Nix software. Viveza is a plugin of Nix software which can sharpen the image very well. But if you use those kind of unsharp mask or image of Nix software, then we will land up with a lot of noise in the frame. And we have to avoid the noise in such kind of photography.
So another question we have, how to locate North Star in the night before you start shooting?
Yeah, simply we have to carry the physical compass. With the compass, we'll get the north direction. Okay, then we have to face our camera towards the north. Certainly we will get the north star exactly in the north direction. And then again, once we know that this is the location of north star, then the part of composition comes. Then we have to locate the location in such a way that we can use the composition as per the location of the north star.
Okay, thank you. We have another couple of different questions we have. Again, a couple of people are asking about the workshop and tour, which we will be sharing your details to them so that they can follow directly with you. Sure. And they can follow you on your Instagram and other social channels.
Yeah, sure.
And some of them have asked about the recording. Yes, recording of this will be available. Recording will be available on Cheese YouTube platform. You go to YouTube and search for cheese.com and you would find a recording of this. Plus, we have like two more questions. We have time for two more questions.
Sure.
Let's take that. Another question we have, people are asking, you know, what are the general question? People have asked that, can you recommend some place, someone? Nakul asked from Chandigarh. We have one question from Chennai, one from Bangalore.
Okay.
So I know, Mukesh, you are from north part of India, but can you suggest some, because some of the people are there from different part of India.
Sure.
Wherever you are aware of, can you suggest some of the places apart from north?
For good landscape, you mean to say?
For astro, yeah.
Yeah, fine. So one is the Kausari I have told you earlier. And then again, Munshiyari is the wonderful place. One more area I have gone almost 8 or 10 years back, that is Chandrasila Parvat. It's located it's in Uttarakhand only. Chopta is there. Chopta area location is there in Uttarakhand. From Chopta, we have to climb around 3 kilometers to reach a temple area. From there, we have to climb around 1.5 kilometers to reach the hilltop of Chandrasila. And I will tell you, it's a very interesting location. I love to go again and again. From that Chandrasila Parvat, if you stand in the morning hour, you can see the complete Himalayan range at 360 degrees. And that kind of location I have never seen anywhere in the country. That's the best location for such kind of photography. But again, we have to climb early in the morning by carrying a torch or anything else. Say around 4 o'clock, you have to start climbing so that you can reach there before the sunrise starts. Because that half an hour to 1 hour time is very, very important to get some wonderful, dreamy and good pictures.
Okay. Any suggestions in some other cities like Chennai or Bangalore or any other location in India?
I have not traveled much in southern states of my country. So I cannot tell about, but the one in Andhra Pradesh I have gone, that is Arku Valley.
Okay,
Arku Valley is also very good locations for landscape as well as for you can say local people, capturing that faces of local people wearing unique type of ornaments. They smoke a different kind of, not cigarette, you can call it bidi or anything, but it's a different altogether. Handmade bidi, they use it. And I had been there and I love that area also.
Many questions we have, Mukesh, asking, during this lockdown time,
Yeah.
Those who wants to, those who never done any astrophotography with limited resources from their rooftop, what experiment they can do to capture some good astro shots?
Yeah, simply from the rooftop, you have to find a some, you can say, apartment or building, or maybe some churches, or maybe some temples or masjid and all, as a foreground. So that key in the background you will get the star tail, and in the foreground you will have some geometrical shapes in form of any kind of architecture. So that will definitely will come out with a wonderful frame.
Okay, any settings for the users, like those who have never done astro, what they can try?
No, the kind of presentation I have given, it's very, 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 very useful. And simply by following these kind of tips, anyone can do it. It's very simple. It's just a question of encouraging ourselves. We can do it. And they definitely will not... during lockdown period, we should not go out. Preferably, we should confine to our own rooftop and do it.
We have a question, like, what is the difference between deep sky and sky photography? Like, what's the primary difference?
Just repeat the question again. In difference between what two?
Deep sky.
Deep.
Yeah, deep sky photography.
Okay, and?
And the regular astrophotography. The normal
sky photography. And first part you told is deep sea.
Deep sky.
Deep sky.
Yeah.
I think I'm not aware about this word, so I can't reply.
Okay, no problem. We have a Devjyoti, Devjit Day. You are unmuted. You can ask your question.
Yeah. Hi, Mukesh. My question was that may I use bulb mode in astrophotography?
Yes, why not?
Because other than taking 100 images, can I take one image in that bulb mode?
In bulb mode, how you will keep the shutter on for such a long period? Unless you use some external timer, you cannot do it. Yeah. Only in one camera, that is probably Nikon 810P, which is made for only astrophotography, you can get the 15 minutes time. In bulb mode, it is very difficult to keep the shutter on for such a long period without getting the camera checked. So best thing is to go for the kind of timer I have shown you. Again, I am showing it, Nikon MC36. This is the best thing.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, thanks.
Thanks, Devjit. And if you, any one of you have any question, please raise your hand. We have a time only for one question now. It's very close to 2 hours. Pradeep, you are unmuted. You can ask your question. Pradeep, you can ask your question.
Yeah, hi. Actually, my question is that in a particular location, how we can identify, like, where is the Milky Way galaxy? Or at what time we can see it?
Yeah, there is a mobile app for that. I think its name is Selenium. You can download from the Play Store. And with that mobile app, you can get the idea about the location and the time. And then you have to plan accordingly. Mostly the Milky Way is visible from the month of April up to the month of September. Again, after October, up to the month of say March, Milky Way is not that much visible in our country. Am I clear?
Okay, great. Thank you. We have the last question from Karan. You are unmuted. You can ask if you can hear us. Okay. Seems like Karan's network is not good. I guess this time to say to close this session. For everyone, we need one request from you. We have a link for donation. We would appreciate if you could donate some money to Prime Minister Fund. That is really very much needed these days, and that would be a bit of our part. Thank you, Mukesh, for such a lovely session. You gave an insight of such a wonderful sky world. We really appreciate that, and thank you for accepting our request to being a part of our show. Mukesh, please, closing thoughts on our end.
Thank you very much. Thank you all the participants and the chiefs. In the last, I will try to say a few words for the participants. See, as I told you earlier, never be crazy in buying anything new. Because what happens कि उसकी साड़ी लाल है तो मेरी भी साड़ी लाल होनी चाहिए. इस चीज को we should forget it. And only when you really need a camera of a very high value, you go for that. If you do not need, even we can carry on with a very basic DSLR, you can do miracle. The most important part is not the camera and the lens. The most important part is your vision. You must improve your vision by seeing the work of senior photographers, because that what we call ki tisri aankh, the third eye. Once you get your third eye open, then you'll see the world differently, and then this type of camera and lens is not very important. So again, I'll repeat it again, that your vision is more important than the tools. Thanks all very much. Anybody, if have got any doubt, they can contact me on my email, or they can send message in my messenger in Facebook or Instagram. Thank you very much.
Sure. Thank you. Thank you, Mukesh. Please do follow him on Instagram. Ask any direct question. If you are interested in his tour or workshop, you would get alerts from his Instagram page.
Yes.
And if you find any difficulty, please contact us. We can share more details with you. And if you have missed any part, the recording will be available in next 60 minutes. You can review that part and go through that. Thank you very much, and sorry we could not accommodate other people. It was, the house was full. Now, thank you very much, Mukesh. Thanks for your time. And guys, you can log off, Mukesh. And if any one of you have any question related to these workshops or anything, yes, certificate will be available. Somebody is asking me. You can claim that certificate by going to our website. There is a link, join.cheese.com. There is a link. You need to send a proof of the email. After this webinar, you will get one confirmation email. You can attach that and send it to us. We will, within 48 hours, you will get your certificate of participation. And thank you, Mukesh, once again. Thank you, everyone. If anyone has any generic question, you guys can ask now. I'll be here for a couple of minutes.
Yeah,
and then we'll call it off. Thank you, Mukesh. You can log off. Thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you very much.
And if anyone has any general question, you can raise your hand, and then we'll take it from there.
feel free to ask any question regarding photography, not only astro photography, anything you want to ask.
Right. Yeah, I think we are all good. Thank you very much, Mukesh. Bye.
Okay, bye. Thank you very much.